not one of us.
Bella, you shouldn't really walk around the woods by yourself anymore. Or at least, not without me.
You don't think I could take care of myself?
I know you can't. And, sometimes, I'm not the most dangerous thing out there.
There was other vampires that killed Waylon, right?
Can you just be more careful?
Maybe my number was up when that van almost crushed me. You know what? Maybe you're just messing around with fate.
Brother, your number was up the first day I met you.
Taste?
Yeah. Oh, you fragile little human. You better hold on tight, spider monkey.
She's brought him to life.
He's been alone too long. How can it end well?
Alice has been wrong before.
Not often.
Carlo, Bella is what he wants. It will work out somehow.
You're a hopeless romantic.
I took the bait.
By tomorrow, they'll be halfway to Winnipeg.
I do love it when men chase me.
So the University of Washington sent me and Eric our dorm assignments yesterday. I'm in the furthest dorm from campus. Eric's in the closest one, of course. Something wrong?
No.
Why? Well, one, Edward's always with you, and two, you keep looking out that window like you're hoping he'll show up and serenade you or something.
Doubtful.
Cool. Okay. We don't have to talk about it.
No, it's nothing. I mean, it is, but... Okay. You remember Jacob Black?
Oh, okay. So, Edward's jealous.
You say that like it's really obvious.
Isn't it? I've seen the way Jacob looks at you. Edward's seen it too. He's only human. He's gonna act like any other guy.
I think it's a little more complicated.
Say the words, Bella. Jealousy.
I've told Jake how I feel. He understands.
Okay. So the word's denial.
He's saying I'm an idiot?
Oh, just a little oblivious.
What? I mean, every move I make, hurt someone.
Bella, they're big boys. They make their own choices. Seriously, don't worry about it. It'll work itself out. It's not life or death.
Yeah.
So make as many mistakes as you can. That way someday when they ask what we want to be, we won't have to guess. We'll know.
Can't wait to see what you're gonna do next. You're my biggest accomplishment.
It's not true.
Yes, it is. Well, you'll see one day when you have kids.
I want you to be happy. I'll understand if you're too angry for me to come to your room tonight. Just keep the window closed.
Whoever it was, he left his stink behind. It'll be hard to miss when we cross it again. We'll handle it from here.
We don't need you to handle anything. Or anyone.
I could care less what you need.
Okay, great. Then we'll all work together. I mean, come on, we've all got the same goals here, right? To catch the bad vampires.
Like there's a difference.
All right. We're done here.
No, you're done here.
Stop! Let go! I'm tired of this. From now on, I'm Switzerland, okay? I know you guys don't like each other, but we've got bigger problems. Lots of them. And this is just one temporary solution. If you'd be willing to try.
A state of terror. Police are baffled by the escalating murders and disappearances. Theories range from a vicious new gang to a wildly active serial killer. Reporting live, Don Chube, CNN.
It's getting worse. We're going to have to do something.
It takes more than one of our kind to cause the damage they're reporting. Quite a few more. And they're undisciplined, conspicuous.
It's newborns.
What, like new vampires?
In the first few months after the change.
That's when we're at our most uncontrollable, vicious, insane with thirst.
Something to look forward to.
No one's trained these newborns, but this isn't random.
Someone's creating an army.
But now we're definitely going to Seattle.
An army of vampires?
And they'd be created to fight someone.
We're the only clan even close to Seattle.
Regardless of why they were made, if we don't put a stop to them, the Volturi will. I'm surprised they've let it go on this long.
Well, maybe they're ignoring it. Or maybe they're behind it. In Italy, I read Arrow's mind. He tried to hide it, but I saw. He wants me and Alice to join him. He thinks our gifts would add to his power. But he knows we'll never choose him as long as our family is still alive.
An army could solve that for him.
Edward, I don't think that we should wait until graduation. I think you should change me now.
Bella, no.
I'm a liability now. I could be an asset.
You'd be a bigger liability as a newborn. Unable to control your instincts. An easy target.
There's also your father to consider. And your mother. Imagine how terrible it would be for them if you suddenly disappeared.
But we're still gonna kick someone's ass, right?
Go blather to someone else about the joys of becoming a newborn.
Okay. Rosalie. I don't understand what I did
to make you hate me so much.
I don't hate you. I don't particularly like you, but Bella, I envy you.
What? That's ridiculous.
No, it's not. You have a choice. I didn't. None of us did, but you do, and you're choosing wrong. I don't care how miserable your human life is.
My life is not miserable. I mean, it's not perfect. And nobody's life is perfect.
Mine was. Absolutely perfect. There were things I still wanted. To be married with a nice house and a husband to kiss me when he came home. Mostly, I wanted a baby.
He never cries.
So much. Aren't you just the best little boy ever? Royce King was the most eligible bachelor in town. I barely knew him. We were never alone. But I was young. I was in love with the idea of love.
What did I say about a low profile? Something's coming. Something bigger than any of us alone. And if you can't control yourselves, we're all going to die. But together, we can crush anything. Do you understand? Do you understand? Now, what's done is done. Just clean up after yourselves.
You saw?
No. Jacob's thoughts are pretty loud.
I don't know what happened.
You love him.
I love you more.
I know. But when I left you bleeding. And Jacob stitched you up. Just left this mark on both of you. And that's my fault.
Don't blame yourself.
I just want you to be happy. No matter how.
Valentina has brought us something.
She should not have interrupted.
She's new.
Aren't they all? L'amore ci mantiene giovane. Edward and Bella are to be married. What joy.
This is the Cullens' way of announcing her transformation. They mock us with their delays.
Patience, brother.
Oh, you do have a point. The human did interrupt.
Oh, I do love weddings.
I personally always knew this was going to happen, but congratulations, guys. I'm so excited for you, Bella. You have been my best friend for a long time now, and I'm so happy to see you as part of my family.
Bella, bro, congratulations. I cannot wait to hear about all your stories on your honeymoon. We love you.
I'm wishing Bella and Edward a long life full of joy, beauty, and love.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are gathered here on this beautiful day to witness the union of Edward Cullen and Bella Swan.
Bella, Edward, just want to wish you the happiest marriage and the longest life together forever.
Do you, Edward, take Bella as your lawfully wedded wife to have and to hold?
To have and to hold.
For better or for worse?
Better for worse.
In sickness and in health?
Sickness and health.
And do you, Bella, take Edward as your lawfully wedded husband to love?
To love.
And cherish?
And cherish.
As long as you both shall live?
Yeah.
I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Edward, it's Seth. I want to say thank you so much for inviting me to the wedding. It was really awesome. Had a good time. My first wedding, actually. And you guys are an awesome couple, and you guys were made for each other.
Edward and Bella, I just wanted to say how very happy I am for both of you. And for a very long time, I thought I knew who was right for Edward. But having seen you both today, and having seen how very beautiful and how extremely happy you both look, I can't wish you anything but huge joy and love forever.
Best wishes to the happy couple. The two of you have been given the most valuable thing anyone can be given in this life. I trust that you will appreciate it and each other every day.
Ah, Bella, you know, from the moment I saw you, Bella, I knew there was something special about you.
Hi, Bella. Hi, Edward. It was a really beautiful ceremony. Bella, you looked really beautiful.
And, I'm not gonna lie, you know, I thought we could have had something together.
I'm so glad that you came into our lives in Forks, that you guys graced us with your presence.
But, you know,
Unfortunately, I looked to my left, and here's the spawn of James Dean and Marilyn Monroe.
Congratulations to you guys, and hope you guys have a great life together.
Well, anyway, he happens to like you, but why wouldn't he? Because you're so great. You're so great, Bella.
Thank you, Edward, for stealing Bella away from me so I can, you know, meet my love of my life.
Congratulations, guys. The wedding was beautiful. Bella, you looked incredible, and I'm just so happy for you guys. I'm gonna miss you so much.
Bella, from the bottom of my heart, I love you. I hope you guys have great lives together. God bless you.
I love you guys.
Farewell.
I'd like to thank Renee and Charlie for bringing such a wonderful person into the world and into our lives. We will cherish and protect her forever.
Love and happiness to you both. I'm so, so happy for you.
Bella Swan. Literally translates to beautiful swan. And that's what you are, Bella, but you never knew it. You never felt like that, you know? You always felt like, you know what I mean? You felt like an awkward duckling. And I don't know why, Bella, because you're perfect. You're perfect, you really are, and you always have been.
It's an extraordinary thing to meet someone who you can bear your soul to, and will accept you for what you are. I've been waiting what seems like a very long time to get beyond what I am. And with Bella, I feel like I can finally begin. So I'd like to propose a toast to my beautiful bride. No measure of time with you will be long enough. Let's start with forever.
I don't know what to say, kid. You're the only thing I've ever really worried about. And I gotta be honest, never been more worried than I am right now. But, you know, it's your life, you gotta live it, so. Edward, I know my daughter loves you more than anything in this world. Just take care of her, that's all that I ask. That's it. That's all I have to say.
My darling Bella and beautiful Edward, I wish you all the happiness in the world and many, many, many adventures together in your life to come. I love you.
Well, hold on, my hair is in my face. Let's do it again. Wait.
Okay.
You keep putting it in my face. I'm sorry.
Towards you.
That
towards
way?
You, yeah.
Okay.
Watch your thumb underneath the hair. Good. And set.
And action.
Welcome home.
Okay.
And set.
You're set.